Right. So now we are going to talk about fetal circulation, right? Fetal circulation will be discussed under three main concepts. Number one, what is normal fetal circulation? Fetal blood circulation, fetal circulation, number one. Number two, first part of the concept. Second part of the concept should be that just after the birth, in the newborn, what are the changes which occur in the fetal circulation or newborn circulation? How the fetal circulatory system changes into newborn or prenatal circulatory system convert into postnatal circulatory system. What are the changes? Right? Changes in fetal circulation, right? So that prenatal circulation convert into postnatal circulatory system. Thirdly, we must talk about that some remnants of the fetal circulation which are not required after the birth. Some components of the fetal circulation which are not required after the birth, those components will degenerate, and what are their adult remnants? Is that right? So what are the adult or postnatal, I must say, what are the postnatal components of fetal circulatory parts which are no more required in function after the birth, right? Now let's start. First we'll talk about normal fetal circulation, right? Now in normal fetal circulation, let's start with the very basic. Okay, let me put here a big fetus. Right? Very happy to come into this world. Wow. Right? Yeah, that's great. It is one in a million. So many sperm were wasted. One sperm reached to the ovum. So it's very proud of it. Right? And now just before birth and after birth, what are the changes? Let me put placenta here. That here is the placenta. And if this is the placenta, what is this here? Umbilical cord, which is connected here. Right? Now, how the fetal circulation starts? Step by step we will go. You know that blood is coming. Baby blood, first of all, fetal blood is going to mother through which arteries? There are two arteries which is taking the blood to mother. What are these arteries which are taking the fetal blood to placenta? This is less oxygenated blood taken from the embryo or fetus to the placenta. Is that right? Through the umbilical cord. What are these two arteries called? Umbilical arteries. Umbilical arteries, right? Then what happens? Umbilical arteries, of course, break down into chorionic arteries and then into what are these? What are these? Chorionic villi, right? This blood which is coming from the baby, it will pass through the chorionic villi and exchange will occur, right? This blood when it is coming, it has oxygen saturation of about 58%. But when it will be going back, it will have oxygen saturation of about 80%. Now what really happens that this blood from all these areas will return back to the fetus, right? Through which vein? Yes, umbilical veins. Initially there are two umbilical veins, is that right? There are two umbilical veins, but as you know from previous lecture that most of the right umbilical vein will degenerate, so only left umbilical vein will be left. and this left umbilical vein, which is taking the blood from the placenta to the embryo proper and eventually to the liver, is it right? So we don't call it now left or right, because right has been completely degenerated. We simply call it umbilical vein. So in the umbilicus, we are having two umbilical arteries and one umbilical vein. Umbilical arteries are bringing the blood from the embryo or fetus to the placenta. Their blood become further oxygenated, it gets oxygenated, and oxygenated blood along with the nutrients and other substances of placenta return to the fetus through what? Umbilical vein. Now we are talking about fetal circulation just before birth, and then I will tell you. So before birth, what is happening here? What is this? Liver, right? You must be knowing that this blood will go to the liver. What is this blood? Umbilical venous blood. It is going to the liver. Is that right? In the liver, as I told you, there are a lot of sinusoids. Right? Some of this blood will go to some of the sinusoids. Last time, I think color of this was different. What was the color of this umbilical in last lecture? This one? Okay, so I will put the same color so that no confusion. Right. So what is happening? This is oxygenated blood. Right? It is going through which? Umbilical vein. And this is entering where? To the liver. In the liver, a small amount of it is going to the sinusoids, but most of it will pass through what? What is this special channel? Ductus venosus. Right? Through the ductus venosus, it will come to the inferior vena cava. There is superior vena cava. This is I'm going to make a heart. What is this? And here was, what was this connected here? Just complete the circuit. Now let me explain it. Blood is coming from placenta through umbilical vein. It is going to the liver. In the liver, very little part of this blood goes to the sinusoid. Most of it will go through specially developed channel, which is called ductus venosus. And then this blood will drain in where? An inferior vena cava. Where it will drain? Through the hepatic venous system. Eventually this will drain into inferior vena cava. But of course, there is one thing, that inferior vena cava is also bringing blood from lower part of the body. Is that right? Right? So this blood, now how much, this blood which was highly oxygenated coming in the umbilical vein, it has mixed little bit with less oxygenated blood, number one, in the liver, right? This is point number one, that this blood which was coming from umbilical vein, which was highly oxygenated, it mixed with the less oxygenated blood, number one, in the liver, but most of it bypasses the liver sinusoid, passes through ductus venosus, go to inferior vena cava. When it comes to inferior vena cava, this blood, what is this blood? Coming from? This also mixes here with blood in inferior vena cava, which is coming from lower part of the body, which is less oxygenated. So how many times it has mixed by now in inferior vena cava? Second time. We are talking about highly oxygenated blood as it is going to the baby. Is that right? Fetus. It has mixed with the less oxygenated blood somewhat in the liver. Then when it went to inferior vena cava, right there again it mixed with less oxygenated blood from the coming from the lower part of the body, and then it drain into right. What is this? This drain into right atrium. In the right atrium, now let me draw the structure here more clearly. Now, in between the right atrium and left atrium, there is a opening, and this opening, which is between the right atrium and the left atrium in the fetus, that is called foramen ovale. And this foramen ovale, right, here is a septum, which is called septum secundum, and it is in the septum secundum. I'm making it S here, right? This is the septum secundum, and septum secundum is having a foramen here, and this opening, right, through which this blood comes into where? From right to left atrium, right? Now, this was the lower inferior, this is inferior vena cava valve. We direct this blood to the foramen ovale, and this is septum, what is this? Secundum. And here, along with septum secundum, here is another septum which is open, and this is septum primum. Now this blood has come to the left atrium. Now listen, first place where highly oxygenated blood mixed with less oxygenated was in the liver. Second place which mixed with the less oxygenated blood was inferior vena cava. Third place where it mixes more oxygenated blood with the less oxygenated blood is right atrium, because look, most of it shunt through the foramen ovale from the right atrium to the left, but a small part of it, right, returns, and here there's less oxygenated blood coming from where? Superior vena cava. And this blood will be going where? To the right ventricle. Some of this blood, which was highly oxygenated, mixed with this and also goes to the right ventricle. But most of the blood, which was highly oxygenated, passes through the foramen ovale to what is that? Right? Left atrium. Then what happens? Now, why there is a shunt present here? Why we want the blood from the right atrium to go to the left atrium? Why we are not allowing all the blood of the right atrium to go to the right ventricle? The answer to this is the right ventricle empty itself into which vessels? Right ventricle empty itself into which vessels? Pulmonary. Is that right? This is pulmonary vessel, and pulmonary, right? Pulmonary arteries. Actually, if all this blood from the right goes to right ventricle, then all of it will be pumped into pulmonary artery, and then it has to go to the lungs. But in the fetus, lungs are not functional, right? Normally in adult, after birth, lot of blood should go to the lungs so that lungs should oxygenate the blood. But baby blood is oxygenated from placenta. So actually, because in the fetus, lungs are not working much, right? So we cannot throw all the blood to the pulmonary vasculature. So we shunt the blood from the right circulation to the left circulation without passing through the lungs. Normally what happens in adult, blood come to the right atrium, then right ventricle, then go to pulmonary circulation, it get oxygenated and come back to the left heart. But in fetus, we are taking the shunting the blood from right atrium to the left atrium, mostly very little blood going to the right ventricle, or whatever amount of blood is coming to the right ventricle, right, it will go to pulmonary artery, whatever is coming here, and in the pulmonary artery, right, now here there is aorta. Here there is aorta. Now what happens that from the left pulmonary artery, there is a very special connection to the aorta. Why we need this connection? Who will tell me? Because we need a connection here because we cannot take this blood. Listen, this blood, it has come to the right ventricle. It is pumped into pulmonary system. We cannot take this blood to the lungs because lungs are not functional. Is that right? So this blood somehow should be prevented to go to the lungs. And secondly, because lungs are collapsed and vessels in the lungs are compressed and there's a high pressure and high resistance in the pulmonary circulation, so this blood cannot go there. So another special channel develops in the fetus which connect the blood from where? From pulmonary arterial system to the aorta. This is called ductus arteriosus. Please don't confuse ductus venosus with the ductus arteriosus. Ductus venosus is a duct in the liver which is connecting the umbilical venous blood to the inferior vena cava blood. Is that right? Ductus arteriosus is a duct connecting to arterial system, pulmonary system with the aorta. Is that right? Now listen carefully. At how many places blood has been mixed? Number one, in the liver. Number two, inferior vena cava. Number three, in right atrium. Then highly oxygenated blood is diverted through the foramen ovale to the left atrium. Through the left atrium, it will come to the left ventricle, and from the left ventricle, it will go to aorta. Is that right? Now remember, from aorta, the vessels which are going to the heart, coronary vessels and cerebral vessels, these vessels which are going to cerebrum, right? Vessels which are going to the myocardium and vessels which are going to the cerebrum, they originate in early part of aorta, which is having highly oxygenated blood. Is that right? Then what happened? Blood from the right ventricle pumped into pulmonary system. It shunts from the ductus arteriosus to where?
Aorta.
And another site where blood is mixed. Right? And now, because this blood which is going from right ventricle, it was coming mainly from upper part of the body, which was deoxygenated blood. Right? And this deoxygenated blood going to the pulmonary circulation and then shunt to, what is this? Aorta. Again, this is a site where there is mixing of, this is the fifth site where there is mixing of highly oxygenated blood, right, reaching aorta with the incoming blood from ductus arteriosus, which is less oxygenated. So how many, five places are there? I've told you only four. One I'm missing. Now that place you will tell me. Number one, highly oxygenated blood mix at liver. Secondly, it mixes at inferior vena cava. Number three, it mixes at right atrium. Number four, it is left atrium, because when this blood goes to the left atrium, very little blood is returning from the lungs, because very little went to the lungs, most of it bypassed. So that little blood which is coming from these lungs, right, which are not fully functional and not ventilated, right, that is also less oxygenated. Is that right? So that is the fourth place. And then eventually blood mixes, more oxygenated blood mixes with the in the aorta from less oxygenated blood coming from the ductus arteriosus, the pulmonary system. Is that right? Then this blood, when it becomes really low oxygenated from the aorta, it is going down, and from there, what are these arteries? Umbilical. So this blood will go into umbilical arteries, and now it will reach where? Yes, placenta, and system will complete its circulation. Now I will repeat the circulation once more, right? Rather, you guys will tell me that circulation we can start from the placenta, right? From the placenta and then back to placenta, how all of it comes back. This is fetal circulation, right? Number one, from the placenta, from the chorionic villi, highly oxygenated blood enter into which vein? Yes? Umbilical vein, right? Then umbilical vein, through the umbilical vein, takes the blood up to liver. In the liver, what is special bypass channel? Ductus venosus. Then this blood comes to inferior vena cava. From there it is diverted to right atrium. In the right atrium, very little mixing. Most of it moves from the right atrium to the left atrium through which foramen? Foramen ovale. In the left atrium, it moves to the left ventricle. From the left ventricle, this blood moves to? What is this? This blood is moving to aorta. Is that right? And meanwhile, the blood which came from upper part of the body and drained from the superior vena cava, when it came to the right atrium, it mixes very little with the blood coming from the inferior vena cava. And then it is pushed to right ventricle. From the right ventricle, it is pushed into pulmonary arterial system. Very little goes to the lung, which will later return to the left heart. Most of it shunt from the pulmonary arterial trunk to the aorta, through which system? Ductus venosus. Okay. Ductus arteriosus. It is not ductus venosus. Ductus arteriosus. And then this blood will pass through aorta, right? And eventually through, what is this? Umbilical arteries, it will come back to the placenta. Any question up to this? Is that right? So now our fetus will come here. Let's explain on him. Mr. Matt. Now we'll explain on him, right? Here is the placenta. Is that right? From the placenta, blood is going through which channel? You people tell me rapidly, please. Yes? Umbilical vein. Then coming up to liver. From there, it is going through ductus venosus. Then it is in inferior vena cava. From the inferior vena cava to the right atrium. Through foramen ovale to the left atrium. Is that right? Now, in the right atrium, blood which comes from inferior vena cava, it goes through foramen ovale to the left atrium. And in the right atrium, blood which is drained from the superior vena cava come to the? Where? Right ventricle, pumped into pulmonary arterial system. But because lungs are not functioning, very little goes to the lungs. Most of it, this blood, which is in pulmonary arterial system, shunt from the pulmonary system through the ductus arteriosus to the aorta. Meanwhile, the blood which has come to the left atrium is pumped into left ventricle and pumped into aorta, and then it's going back and through the aorta, through which arteries will come back to placenta? Umbilical. Any question up to this? There's no question. Thank you. Have a seat. Now, after birth, we are going to the second concept. Right? After birth, what are the changes which occur in this fetal circulation? After birth, immediately after birth, what are the changes? Listen, as soon as baby is born, two most important things will occur. Number one, baby will start breathing and start its own respiratory system and ventilation. Secondly, baby is disconnected from placenta. Is that right? Placenta is no more the major provider to the baby. Is that right? Now, tell me one thing. As soon as baby is born, do we need placenta to serve the baby? No. So it means that we actually cut down, what is this? No, we cut down umbilical cord. When we cut down the umbilical cord, it means, what is this? Umbilical vein and umbilical arteries, right? They are no more needed. So what are the things which we don't need? Of course, number one, we don't need the services of umbilical artery. We don't want, after the birth, baby blood going to the placenta. Right? First, umbilical arteries constrict. And immediately after that, umbilical veins also constrict. Is that right? So they are closed. But actually the real most important event is, as soon as baby is born, right, baby will start its first cry or first inspiration. When baby will start its first cry, lungs will expand. What will happen? Lungs will expand. When lungs will expand, look at these. Let's suppose these were baby's lung, right? And what was coming here? Okay, I'll make these lungs a little away. And what was coming here? Pulmonary artery going to the lungs. before the birth, what was happening? Of course, there was aorta here, right? And there was a very special connection here up to this. What was this connection? Ductus arteriosus. Is that right? Now, what was happening before the birth? That blood from the right ventricle was going to the pulmonary arterial system, but because before the birth these channels were closed mostly, so blood was shunted where? To aorta before the birth. But just after the birth, the baby takes its first inspiration and lungs expand. When baby's lung expand, right? So what will happen? As lungs stretch out, these vessels will also open. The wide bore vessels open. Now resistance of blood flow to the lungs will become more or less. Less. So what happened? As soon as previously baby was not breathing and lungs were collapsed and it was difficult for the blood to pass through the lungs, and it is good. Baby is not breathing inside uterus. You know that. Good. Now, what happens? As soon as baby is born and first inspiration start, lungs expand. When lungs expand, then resistance in pulmonary circulation become less. When resistance in pulmonary circulation become less, then blood start going to, what is this? Pulmonary circulatory system. So that, because now placenta will not be providing the oxygenated blood, oxygenation should occur in where? Yes, in the lungs. From the lungs, what happened? Well oxygenated blood, of course, will return to the which heart? Left heart, left atrium, right? Is that right? And then from there, it will be, of course, pumped into, what is this? From here into left ventricle, and then from there it is to the aorta. Now listen, what is the special change? As soon as baby breathes, lungs expand, resistance to the pulmonary circulation become less, and blood which was previously going from right ventricle to pulmonary artery through previously going through ductus arteriosus to the aorta, rather than that, it loves to go to very less resistance to the lungs. When this blood goes to the lungs, it becomes highly oxygenated, baby is breathing. And this highly oxygenated blood, right? Now this green blood, of course that is not green, but in my diagram, this green blood is which is coming, right? That is low oxygenated or highly oxygenated? It is from this lung and that. This highly oxygenated blood will be pumped into it, aorta. When it is moving through aorta, a very important thing will happen. Now pressure in aorta is high and pressure in pulmonary artery is low. Why? Because previously, because there was no blood going to the lungs, right? So there was very less blood because their pulmonary circulation was not working. Previously, pulmonary circulation was not working. So total blood coming to the left ventricle was less. So blood going into aorta was also less. But as soon as, and previously before birth, when lungs were collapsed, there was very high resistance in this system. And before the birth, because pulmonary system was highly resistant, blood was moving from pulmonary to aorta. But just after first breathing, pulmonary system pressure fall a lot. Is that right? And this oxygenated blood which is coming to the left heart and going into aorta, aorta become high pressure system, and now relatively pulmonary system become low pressure system. Here now, shunt will reverse. Highly oxygenated blood will move shunt from aorta to the pulmonary system through the ductus arteriosus. Now remember, ductus arteriosus is very, very sensitive to three things. Number one, it is very, very sensitive to oxygen. When high amount of blood with high oxygen passes through this, a smooth muscle construct. Number one. Number two, from the lungs, when lungs undergo first inflation, they release bradykinin. And this bradykinin also come, and when it is passing through this, bradykinin also constricted. So first constrictor was blood with high oxygen. Secondly, bradykinin coming from lungs, first inflation of. Thirdly, when oxygen is very high in the blood, then listen carefully. Previously, the cells in the ductus arteriosus, they were releasing prostaglandin E2. What they were releasing here? PG, E2, right? Prostaglandins. Previously, before the birth, and these cells, local cells in ductus arteriosus, produce prostaglandin at low oxygen tension. When they are producing prostaglandin, prostaglandin keep ductus arteriosus open, open. It keeps it open. But just after the birth, when highly oxygen loaded blood passes through ductus arteriosus, even very little it passes, what happens? Prostaglandin production become less. And when prostaglandin production become less, there's high oxygen in blood, high bradykinin, and there's low prostaglandin. Prostaglandin become less. Prostaglandin cannot keep the smooth muscles relaxed. So there's failure of dilation, and again it constrict. So what is happening? Just after the birth, with first breathing, lung expand, resistance to pulmonary circulation become less, blood start moving to the lungs rather than going from pulmonary system to the aorta through ductus arteriosus, and blood which is returning from the lungs, number one, it has high amount of oxygen, secondly, it has high amount of bradykinin. And when this blood passes through aorta, now pulmonary system is low pressure system, aorta is high pressure system, little blood trickle from aorta to the ductus arteriosus. High oxygen inhibits the production of prostaglandin, so it cannot remain dilated. At the top, when bradykinin come also here, that also constrict. So ductus arteriosus will temporarily undergo constriction and block. Is that right? Am I clear? Now, let's see again and come back here. Another thing. When ductus arteriosus block, what will happen? Come back here. Now, because baby has done its first breathing, lot of blood has gone to the lungs and coming to the left atrium. So pressure in left atrium will go up or down? Up. So why pressure in the left atrium just after birth goes up? Because lot of blood is returning from the newly started pulmonary circulatory system. And this blood which is returning from the lungs to the lungs to the left atrium, it increases the left atrial pressure. At the same time, just after the birth, blood coming from umbilical vein has stopped. Umbilical veins constrict. And when blood, either they are cut off or they constrict. Now when umbilical veins is not providing the blood, then total blood coming to the right atrium has been reduced. So what happens? Just after the birth, right atrium has less blood coming to it due to closure of umbilical veins, and left atrium has more blood coming to it because of more blood coming from pulmonary circulation. So pressure in right atrium goes down, pressure in left atrium goes up. What will be the effect of that? Let me show you. That let's suppose that here is right atrium. And there is left atrium. Now, what is happening really here is that here was communication between the right and the left. And this communication was made by which foramen? Foramen ovale, which was a hole in the septum. Secundum, is that right? In septum secundum. And on other side, what was this here? Septum primum. Previously, what was happening? That pressure in the right atrium was more before the birth, and left was less, so blood was moving in this direction. Is that right? But now pressure in the right atrium has become less, and pressure in the left atrium has become more, and that increased pressure in the left atrium, which is coming due to return of the blood from the lungs, that will press, what is this? septum, primum, and press it and push it on the foramen ovale. So foramen ovale will be temporarily closed. Remember, all these shunts which close initially they are temporarily closed. It takes many months that eventually they will become fibrotic. Foramen ovale eventually completely anatomically close on first birthday of the baby by that time, 1 year. Is that right? And in 20% of the people it never closes. It has a little communication there. But anyway, any question up to this? Now, let's start the changes which are occurring in fetal circulation as soon as fetus is born. So what are the changes going on in newborn baby circulation, converting the prenatal circulatory pattern into postnatal circulatory pattern? We'll start from the beginning and we move up to the end. Is that right? One by one. Number one, change. What will be there? From this side we are starting. Is that right? What is this thing? Yes? There is closure of? There is contraction of umbilical vein. But remember, actually umbilical arteries contract first and then umbilical vein contract. You know why? First we should stop the blood going to the placenta and let the blood return to the fetus and then close it, so that placenta should be somewhat drained back. Am I clear? So what happened? Number one, pulmonary arteries constrict. Is that right? So blood going to the placenta stop. We don't need placental circulation now, baby is born. Secondly, umbilical artery constrict, right? And thirdly, sinus. What is this now? Ductus venosus closes. Is that right? Next is, as I told you, due to the first breathing and the pulmonary circulation has started in a good way. So left atrial pressure has become more, and because umbilical venous blood is not coming, so right atrial pressure is less. So foramen ovale closes by the valve of foramen ovale, which is septum primum, which opposed itself against the septum secundum to close the foramen ovale, and in the end a little depression left in the wall is called fossa ovalis. Is that right? So again, umbilical veins will constrict, then ductus venosus will close down, then foramen ovale is blocked. Is that right? Because of pressure in the right atrium is less and left is more, and then you are moving forward. What is this? Because now blood is going to the lungs, ductus arteriosus constrict. Is that right? In this way, what is the in the end, what is this? This also block. What is this? Right? So how many changes occur at 5 level? Number 1, umbilical vein and arteries. 2 and 3 shunts. What are the major 3 shunts operating in fetus? Number 1 is ductus venosus. Number 2, foramen ovale. Number 3 is ductus arteriosus. What are the 3 shunts? Ductus venosus in the liver, foramen ovale between the right and left atrium, and ductus arteriosus, which is between the pulmonary circulation and aorta. Is that right? So there are 5 changes just after the birth. 2 are very easy to remember. Number 1, umbilical vessels should close down. Do you think you need to memorize this? Everyone should know that umbilical cord is cut. So umbilical vein and arteries shut down. Secondly, when umbilical system is shut down, do we need an respiratory system has started? Do we need all these shunts? No. So what is that? Ductus venosus closes down, foramen ovale closes down, ductus arteriosus closes down. Is that right? And adult pattern or postnatal pattern is developed now. What is the postnatal pattern? That whatever blood is coming to, first of all, listen, in postnatal pattern, there's no blood going to placenta, no blood coming from the placenta. Is that right? So whatever blood is coming through inferior vena cava and superior vena cava, coming to the right atrium, then to the right ventricle, not shunting here. And through the right ventricle, going to the pulmonary artery, again, not shunting here, and going to the lungs. And from the lungs, returning to the left ventricle, and then to the aorta, and going to the all body, and then returning back to the caval system, and this placental circulation is excluded. Is that clear? Now the last part of this lecture. is what are the adult or postnatal remnants of the fetal circulatory components. Number one, we start from here now. Yes, number one, what is this? Okay, I will put with some different color now. Color I will put green. Number one, what is this? Umbilical vein. When it closes down, and it becomes fibrotic, what is left behind? Ligamentum? Teres. Ligamentum teres. Secondly, when, what was this? Ductus venosus also become closed and fibrotic in the end. With the time, what is this? Ligamentum venosum. So I will start writing here. What was this? Okay. Postnatal component. Number one was? Ligamentum teres. Number two, what was this? Ligamentum venosus. Number three, when it is moving and foramen ovale is closed, and at that point what is left? Fossa ovalis. Fossa ovalis. And next, blood which is going here, it is not shunting here, and this is closed. What is this? Ductus arteriosus is closed. And what is this now? Yes, ligamentum arteriosum. Is that right? And in the end, we are not having these vessels working. What are these vessels? Umbilical arteries. A little part of it work as internal iliac arteries. Some of it supply the blood to urinary bladder, superior vesicle arteries. But this all closes. And this closed and fibrotic component is called which ligament? Medial? Yes, medial. Medial umbilical ligament. Umbilical ligament. So these are the derivatives or component present in adult, which are originally, you can say, remnants from the which circulation? Fetal circulation. Everyone has been a fetus once in a lifetime. Is that right? So again, now rapidly tell me and we'll close the lecture. Yes, what is this? It will close into what? Umbilical vein will convert into ligamentum teres. Say it loudly. Ductus venosus will convert into ligamentum venosus. Foramen ovale will convert into fossa ovalis. And ductus arteriosus will convert into? Yes? Ligamentum arteriosum. And umbilical arteries, their remnants are three. Number one, internal iliac arteries. Number two, superior vesicle arteries. And number three, what is this? Medial? Right? Medial ligament, right? But these two are functional, internal iliac artery and what is this? Superior vesicle. So if someone asks which are the non-functional derivative of the umbilical arteries, you will tell only medial umbilical ligament. And if someone asks what are the three important shunts in the fetal circulation? Ductus venosus, foramen ovale, ductus arteriosus. Now last but not least, that some babies have, after the birth, ductus arteriosus does not close properly. We call it patent ductus arteriosus. This type of problem, ductus arteriosus does not close properly, or for some time it keep on working, especially seen in premature babies. Is that right? Number one. Number two, what we can do about it? Because this is not good to have it open. If ductus arteriosus remain open, then blood from the aorta keep on shunting to pulmonary, and then blood going to the lungs will become too much. Number one, blood coming from caval system to the right heart, pumped to the pulmonary artery and going to the lungs. Number two, blood reversing back from the aorta and coming to the pulmonary circulation. So lungs will become overloaded with blood. Right? This is not good. Right? Overload of over-circulation. Secondly, if this is open, there will be special type of murmur that all the time, all the throughout the cardiac cycle, aorta pressure remain higher than the pulmonary artery pressure. So during systole and diastole, blood is moving from aorta to the pulmonary artery. During systole, pressure differential is more. So there's high amount of blood moving, shunting, right? And during diastole, less amount. So this abnormal flow of blood produces an abnormal sound which is called murmur. And this murmur is during systole and diastole changes in its in intensity, right? During systole, so during systole it goes up, during diastole it becomes less. During systole it goes up, diastole it becomes less. This is called machinery-like murmur, as some machine is working there. Little working more than less, than more than less. Is that right? Machinery-like murmur, that is also a feature of patent ductus arteriosus. How we can close it? We don't want it to remain open. One way is we give a drug called indomethacin. Indomethacin is a drug which inhibits the enzyme which produces prostacycline. So prostaglandin. So if we give the baby indomethacin, prostaglandin production becomes less, and prostaglandin is one of the factors which can keep this dilated. So when prostaglandin level goes too much down, this will close. And in some cases, when this thing cannot, indomethacin cannot close it, we can surgically ligate it. Right? That is something about the patent ductus arteriosus. Do you have any question about the fetal circulation? Really, no? Class dismissed.